Could we get a contender for the GoDaddy knockout of the night here? It's most likely. Big Dash fires the right hand down the tube.
I'm not liking how DeAndre's leaning back with that, as you can kind of see him fainting, the Big Dash fainting in, and DeAndre's kind of leaning back with his chin up in the air. He's got to be careful with that. Big Dash might come straight down the middle. He's also throwing those wheel kicks real well.
Ataudis has been known to fly, to get airborne with those lunging knees. Scooping shot there from Ataudis, nowhere near the target, goes to the inside lower leg. Big Dash looking very focused, very calm. Moving well, the balls of his feet, the Russian.
DeAndre's pushing forward, backing up Big Dash up against the cage. Big Dash starts to circle out. DeAndre's fainting. Calf kick.
Still a filling out process by both of these men. Ataudis still controlling center cage. Look at them staring each other down, analyzing each other's technique and their movement, the angles.
I do like how Ataudis is changing levels. You can see that nice little pop that he's doing, a little squat, just kind of threatening the takedown a little bit. I like seeing him shoot in, though, a little bit. Throw some punches, going for a double leg test. Ooh.
Counter overhand right there from Big Dash came close. And Ataudis still controlling center cage, forcing the Russian to the outside. Some cagey movement here from Vitaly. Big Dash looks for a counter overhand right off the leg kick.
See the hush kind of fall over the crowd. Everybody's waiting for one big shot to come flying in.
One championship needed to have only have sold the edge of the seats for this one, because everyone here in Jakarta is on the edge of their seats.
They paid for the whole seat, but they don't need it tonight.
Ataudis cocking that left hand in southpaw stance right now. The Brazilian has got some heavy leather. And Big Dash saying, come on, let's see what you've got. Challenging Ataudis to come forward.
Big Dash is waiting for the counter strike. He wants Ataudis to come rushing in so he can counter. But that's what Ataudis just did.
Big Dash has only lost when he lost the world title to Ong Lan Sang. How he'd love a trilogy match with Ong La in Yangon. Ataudis edges forward in orthodox stance now. He has been switching all round.
His hands are real low, but he's keeping that right hand near his chin, but that left hand is coming from different angles. You can see him raise it up really fast and kind of split in the guard of Big Dash.
Both these athletes still in first gear. Thought about a counter overhand right there. Did Big Dash fakes the back kick and resets.
Like seeing DeAndre go back to that leg kick. That calf kick worked really well. Like seeing him go back to it again. Slow down the movement of Big Dash. Get him stationary.
We've seen Big Dash drift into the right hand of Ataudis. There he goes again, drifting off to his left into Ataudis' right. Showing no respect for the power hand of the Brazilian. Inside leg kick, nicely placed there from Vitaly Big Dash. Jab two from Ataudis. Outside leg
kick
from
the Brazilian. 1 minute left in the first round.
Still a filling up process, do you feel here, Mitch?
I think so. I think they're just trying to get a read on each other, understand the distance and timing, but especially with Ataudis changing back and forth between southpaw and orthodox, it's hard for Big Dash to get a read on him. But then Big Dash is also kind of, you know, gyrating his hand movements, kind of not giving DeAndre exactly the taste that he's looking for.
Good check of the low kick. Double check there from Ataudis. Jab two from the Brazilian, still in center cage. As it has been all round, with Big Dash on the outside, there was a nice high check from Ataudis.
This is a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu world champion checking leg kicks, Michael. That is impressive.
His striking has improved out of sight over the last 12 to 18 months, Ataudis. Front kick there from Big Dash.
He's incredibly relaxed and comfortable in there. He's marching forward, hands are down, pushing the pace, creating a lot of the action here.
Spinning back fist there from Ataudis. What does concern me about DeAndre, though, he is carrying his hands very low, His weight is forward and his chin is hanging out there, Mitch.
Yeah, but that's kind of his style. I would like to see the chin get tucked. The hands down, you know, that's okay, but because he's coming from different angles, but you can see, you know, whatever hand he's, you know, his rear hand, it does come up near his chin, and he's delivering some awkward shots with that lead hand. So you can't really quite see where they're coming from. If you got a high guard, like Big Dash does, you can see where those punches are coming straight at you. But when it's down, it comes from odd angles.
Just take a look, folks, at the legs of the feet of Ataides and count how many times he switches stance already. And we're just about a minute down in this second round. He must have switched at least 8 times. Which is he more comfortable in, do you feel? The southpaw or the orthodox stance, Mitch?
Pretty sure he's an orthodox athlete, but you know, he seems very comfortable out of that southpaw stance. And he's moving around very well, and it's given another wheel kick coming from Big Dash, but it's given Big Dash some problems. He's not able to initiate anything. He's waiting for Leandro to come at him, and then he's going back to attack himself.
So when we say southpaw, it's as now with right foot forward, left hand being the power hand. When we say orthodox, it's as now with the left foot forward, the right hand being the power hand. So you'll see Ataides constantly switch between the two to confound Big Dash. Never let Big Dash know where the power is coming from. And it means that Big Dash has to constantly adjust also, Mitch.
Very true. And you can see that by Leandro cutting the angles of where Big Dash is going. So if Big Dash starts to circle to the left, you can see him switch stances so that he goes into his right hand. Once Big Dash starts to circle to the right, Leandro switches back to southpaw so that Big Dash is circling into his power side again.
BJJ World Champion putting on some fantastic strike. Oh, he tags it! A beautiful counter right hand, smack bang on the kisser. And Big Dash does a quick count of his teeth.
I like the acknowledgement they both had. Big Dash goes, yep, you got me. And Leandro goes, yeah, I got you.
Mitch, do you feel these two men, given the high stakes that are up here tonight, are holding back a little too much?
Now, I don't think Leandro's holding back. He's picking his shots very carefully. Big Dash seems a bit hesitant. He's not really pushing forward with this sort of linear, aggressive, straight-on kickboxing style that we've seen from him in the past. He's letting Leandro control the center, back him up against the cage, and the way Leandro's changing stances, very the way that he's circling, just as Leandro misses a big knee there, Leandro's feeling very confident at this point.
We did see Leandro shooting for a double leg in the final second of the opening round, but no signs of a takedown attempt here in the second round.
I don't think he needs to. I think he's doing a very good job on his feet. And I could say this right as Big Dash unloads a huge shot, but see how he changed to southpaw again as Big Dash was circling to the right. So you can see that Big Dash starts to circle into the power. Once Big Dash starts to move to the left, Leandro goes back to orthodox.
Big Dash went for a liver shot, then threw a high left roundhouse, but pulled it back halfway. 1:20 remains, second round of action. Been some good signs, some good glimpses from Leandro Ataides.
Good check.
I just feel that Big Dash hasn't found the flow, hasn't found the rhythm. He's lining up the one big punch, but not accompanying it by setting up with a jab or the leg kicks or a hook first.
He's not
1 minute left in the second round.
That's what he needs to do. He needs to start putting pressure on Leandro.
And he's not initiating, Mitch. He's allowing Leandro to initiate most of the attacks here. And Mitch, I've got to ask you, the expert, the question, why? Why is Big Dash playing this game? Why is he not initiating that?
Ooh, just went up there with a big high kick. You know, I can't say why. Maybe it's because he's not feeling himself. Maybe he's trying to be strategic, trying to lure Ataides into something that Leandro's open to with his hands down, his chin up in the air, and he's able to hit him. But the confidence and the swagger coming off Ataides right now is very impressive. Allah is probably watching this very intently, breaking him down on a different level.
Getting back fist there from Ataides. Ataides has controlled the center of the cage the entire contest so far. In the third round, which is where we're going to go very soon, we've got to see Big Dash do something different. And again, will he try and stamp his authority in Shenzhou Gay?
See, just now he went first. He's starting to move forward. He's starting to throw the combinations. That's what Big Dash is known for.
This is a little more like it from Vitaly Big Dash. Oh, jumping knee! Ataides, you know he's planted opponents like trees with that flying knee before. Jab from Big Dash, not giving up center cage so easily now. Hook from Big Dash. High on the balls of his feet, counter overhand right from the Russian.
Andre's head movement is pretty slick right now. I know his chin's up, his hands are down a little bit when he's drifting back, but his head is nowhere to be found.
High kick, the headache maker from Vitaly Big Dash.
But his hand was up, DeAndre blocked that.
And again, we get this situation of a switch stance. Leandro Ataides controlling center cage, pressing Vitaly Big Dash to the outside. Big Dash, counter right hand down the center. Inside leg kick was a nice one. Jab from Ataides. Jab two from Big Dash. Last time we saw Big Dash in action, he did hang back and he was disappointed by the decision that was given to him, Mitch. Is he making the same mistake here? Is he holding back too much?
I mean, it's obvious that he might be holding back a little bit now. He's not pushing forward the way he normally does. But now we're starting to see in the third round, he's starting to become more active. He's throwing more strikes and initiating attacks.
Do you think he's waiting to go kleptomaniac and steal the round in the final minute and a half?
I mean, he might be trying to do that, but I mean, this is not a championship match. This is not five rounds. He's got less than 3 minutes to put a huge punctuation in this round and in the match.
And more than that, there's so much at stake. It's not a world championship match, but a world championship spot is up for grabs.
But right now, we gotta pay attention to Leandro. I think it's more the fact that Leandro is confusing Big Dash rather than Big Dash holding back. The constant switching of the stances, the incredibly relaxed attitude from Ataides, and the big uppercut.
Here comes Leandro. He chooses to take him down. Can he finish it now? Big Dash is hurt. The ground and pound. The monstrous ground and pound. The London that I made. That was awesome. It's going to be Ataides versus Ong Lan Sung in Myanmar for the World Championship.
Leandro Ataides just punched his ticket to Yangon, Myanmar to meet the one middleweight world champion. Let's take a look at it again. Big Superman punch, wobbled Big Dash. Leandro, sensing the end was in sight, goes for the takedown, gets on top, and starts raining down the ground and pound. Number one contender, Leandro Ataides.
Number one indeed, number one with a stunner. Look at the ground and pound from Ataides. Olivia Cole saving.
Your winner by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, Leandro Ataides.
With what is your contender for the Go Daddy knockout of the night? Leandro Ataides seals a world championship tilt against the champ Ong Lan Sung in Yangon, Myanmar. Overcome with emotion here, Leandro Ataides.